Next physical quantity to discuss in your book is speed. So we have topic calculation of speed. Speed is a very common word that we use in day-to-day life. Speed is what the present generation also requires. Everybody wants to do their work fast. Nobody likes a person who does work slowly. Even teachers ask students, you know, when suppose any teacher giving notes, then teacher tells, okay, write fast, we have something else to discuss also. Okay, then you have to very fast, you have to write down the note. Then the days also pass by very soon, as you must be realizing. So soon the year has passed. Just a few days back only we had begun with 2021, now it has come to April. Soon this April month also is going to end. So the world goes on, the work in this world also goes on very fast. We also do our work. So speed is the key word. We need the speed in our life. Okay, that's a different topic to discuss. Coming to physics. Now speed is how fast or how slow an object moves. Okay, object moves from one place to another. But how fast or how slow it moves is known as speed. So the formula for speed is distance by time. Keep this in mind. Formula for speed is distance by time. How much distance an object is moving and how much time that object is taking to move that distance. Alright? So if more distance is covered in less time, we say speed is more. If less distance is covered in that same particular time, then the speed is less. Alright, so we have the units again, SI and CGS units. SI is standard international unit. In SI unit, we have the unit as meter per second. Okay, in short for meter is M, second is S, so meter per second is oblique is the division line. Okay, here like this line is symbolizing division, this oblique also symbolizes division. Alright, then you have in CGS unit, instead of meter, we have centimeter. So centimeter per second. Short form of centimeter is CM, small letter C, small letter M. In this case also, M is small letter, S is small letter. There is one other unit also that we follow when we drive vehicles. Kilometers per hour. You must have seen speedometers in vehicles, whether it is a scooter or it's a bike or a car or a truck or a train. This dial, there is a dial in the speedometer and it indicates the speed in kilometers per hour. How many kilometers traveled in a given hour? So that's the other unit of speed, kilometer per hour. Alright, so these are the things that are related with speed. So we have actually finished this chapter. In the next class, we will start solving the numerical problems related with density, speed, and previous to that, we have studied volume and area. So we will try solving the question answers and numerical problems of these particular topics: volume, area, and then today what we discussed, density and speed. Thank you for attending the class today.